Take a lesson.
Yeah.
Hold a lesson. Infection. And then you talk a little bit about long-term home infection. So, bleeding. Up till today, bleeding is a proper treatment for surgery. In the middle age, the function of blood was completely unknown. It was some mystical thing, it was red, it was warm, it was salty, tasted by metal. But they didn't know what it was for exactly. They only knew that it was recruited here, so it's much bigger in a short time. Also, they had no real concept of blood circulation. Did you ever think about my arteries are named arteries? The blood vessels that go from the body. Because when they slaughter the animal, a pig or whatever, and they let it out and then cut it apart, they found tubes in the body that went everywhere. They are somehow connected to the heart and somehow connected to the lung. And the lung was filled with air, so these vessels were empty, also filled with air, so they are thought those tubes were somehow used for ventilating air into the body. That's the most probable origin of the term artery. It's used today for blood vessels that pump blood from the heart in the periphery of the body. But I didn't know what those vessels were good for. So, they had also little knowledge concerning blood clotting. What happened when blood clotted? Why? What was to be done? If it was excessive clotting, what would have to be done if there was no clotting? They had some solutions for excessive clotting. Today, in modern surgery, steam heat is used to see blood vessels. Heat is produced by electricity or by sonic measures, ultrasonic. They used hot oil, molten lead, red hot iron, or even red powder. Oh. Yeah.
If the bleeding didn't get you, maybe the shock would have came.
And if they succeeded in stopping the bleeding, they ran into another problem, we will talk later, infection. Because we have a large area of dead bacteria, and that is a clear playground for bacteria. Then, they would stop the bleeding by compression. As they had no idea how blood was transported to the body, they had no concept for, let's say, pressure damage or something like that. Maybe they did something, maybe they tried to press something on the wound, but it was probably not effective. And I'm not sure if there were any surgical methods to stop bleeding to the inside of the body, bleeding into muscles. You can use a lot of blood in the muscle. In the thigh, you can use about 2 liters. And the abdomen can maybe 10, 12 liters. 2 times your entire blood volume. So, let's talk about shock. What is a shock? Shock is a mismatch of the volume of blood that is in the system and the canal of the arteries. If you lose too much blood, and the periphery of the body no longer has enough oxygen. So the body tries to solve the problem in cutting off the periphery and only letting blood to the vital organs. People in shock get pale, cold, blue, shiver. That's the effect of the periphery that is shutting off the blood flow. this doesn't work or goes on too long. All the body material is no oxygen or less oxygen. We produce, let's say, messengers that tell the arteries in their neighborhood to open up again because they want blood, they need oxygen. And if they do open up their own arteries, the pressure in the entire system falls deeper and deeper and deeper. And then we call it a total pump shock or a total knee shock. Until today, this is almost impossible to stop. What we see today in prolonged shocks is a successive organ failure. Kidney, liver, lung shut off, work no longer. If the lung shuts off, there is no more oxygen in the body. And at last, the heart stops for oxygen starvation. And of course, in the middle age, there was no efficient shock therapy because they had no possibility of IV. And of course, no blood temperatures or something like that, no blood transfers. Infection. Until today, infection is one of the greatest problems in surgery. Do you want any advice? Stay out of hospitals if you get infections there. Very bad infections. Because why? Because of abuse or overuse of modern antibiotics, and so the bacteria get resistant and get very dangerous. And having infections of certain patients are often uncontrollable. Many patients are lost due to infection. Was completely unknown. We didn't have the slightest idea what caused this phenomenon, the, what we call it today, intervention in syndrome. The thought was something in the air, in the water, something steaming out of the ground, or brought in by evil spirits or whatever. Festering was seen as a good omen because they saw that every wound that healed was in the process of festering before that. So if a wound, which was seldom but impossible, did not fester, they opened it up again and took care that it festered. They did these experiments, thought experiments, very often used to provoke this type of festering. Why dog? Don't know. But they also used hair of horses. Then, if an infection got out of hand, they had of course no concept of sepsis and toxic shock and therapy. If this festering spread into the body and reached other organs, you were lost. They couldn't do anything to you. Besides, maybe if waiting and praying or trying some herbs, or maybe they try to save you by amputation.
Was, was heißt festering auf Deutsch?
Eitern.
Okay.
If they tried amputation, then you had the same problems again. The bleeding, the stopping of the bleeding, the large area of bad material, maybe an infection. So, long-term consequences, of course. We heard in the first question that stabbing or using point or tips of weapons was prohibited by, because stabbing injuries were almost always fatal in the end. You come relatively easy into the body, you bring material from the clothes or from the skin inside the body, and you have infections that are uncontrollable in the medieval times. Maybe you could survive a stab in the lung, could live with one lung. But a stab in the abdominal cavity. A standard abdominal cavity was always rather weak. We could always die from excessive muscle damage. If muscles are crushed, they give up, they give free proteins, which are washed away by the blood and come to the kidneys and may block the kidney function. We noticed today in the modern trauma surgery is compartment syndrome, and the damage to the kidneys is crushed kidney. This can lead to complete kidney failure and might mean that you need dialysis or transplant. Then immobility caused by the injuries or by infections could always kill you because of blood clotting, of pneumonia, or of ulcer you get from lying in the bed. Blood clotting happened or will happen in your big veins, mainly in the veins of the legs. These blood clots will reach the heart, and then the lung will block the third passage of the blood through the lung in the body and back to the heart. And then will kill you. Pneumonia, if you lay down long enough, you will get pneumonia even today. It's very common. And even this is today a big problem of people who are bedridden. If you, it takes only a few hours if you lie on a hard floor like here. With your head on the floor. About 2 or 3 hours and you have an ulcer to the bone. The pressure of your head on the floor is sufficient to destroy the tissue and you have an infection that spreads very fast to the bone. And of course if you lay on your back and you have all these injuries, ulcer on your back and they are infected, then it was a problem of school. They didn't have the equipment that we have today to wash and care for patients that cannot move. So if you were far enough, you could be, I don't think you had a big chance of survival. And even if you did, disability of a farmer could kill his entire family. If you could work no longer and if his children are too small and wife not able to care for the farm, there was no social security, no money. So, thank you.